Hello, in this PixaFlux view tutorial you will learn how to create bevel and emboss features for normal images using the Relief and ToNormal nodes. The Relief node takes a color image as input, converts it to a monochromatic image and generates a transition between the different levels of the image. The ToNormal node converts this monochromatic image to a normal image. In this project I have a PBR graph with three features, some text, a shape, and a door gap. We'll use the Relief node to increase the bumpiness of these features. The Relief node is located in the 3D nodes toolbar submenu. Drag the node and drop it on top of the text to the ToNormal cable. Select the ToNormal node and set it as the display node by pressing the D key. Increase the radius to 10. Check the Grow checkbox to increase the size of the output image. The Relief node has 5 styles: Levels, Inner Bevel, Outer Bevel, Emboss, and Pillow Emboss. Set the style to Outer Bevel. There are 4 profile options: Linear, Smooth, Arc Out, and Arc In. Set the profile to Smooth. The Soften value applies a Gaussian blur to the source image. Set Soften to 3. The main advantage of generating a monochromatic image from the Relief node is that it can be used by other nodes in the graph. Connect the output of the Relief node to the mask input. For this shape, we'll use a Relief node with the Levels style. Drag a new Relief node to a cable between the Shape node and the ToNormal node. This shape has different gray scales. The Levels profile creates a ramp between the levels without changing their value. This creates realistic interconnected 3D effects between the elements, as you can see here. Set Soften to 3. For the door gap, we'll use a Relief node with an outer bevel. This shape is also used to increase ambient occlusion at the gap. Drag a new Relief node to the cable between the Shape node and the ToNormal node. Set the style to Outer Bevel. Set the radius to 10. Set Profile to Arc In. Set Soften to 2. The gap looks as if popping up. In the ToNormal node, set Multiply to -1 to invert the effect. Set the filter to 7x7. Now that the graph is fully rigged, any node can be edited to modify multiple images in real time. Iterations are extremely fast, and changes in one node can affect all your PBR textures in the project. Thank you for watching this video tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.